are the brothers or the abbot's men?
I would say well met, brother, but I cannot shake off the needle itch of dread. Is something wrong?
I followed the abbot here, kept him in my sight. But the monks, his servants, I have seen nothing of them.
Dead?
I do not think so. But there is no good here in this grave hush.
And where is the abbot now?
In his quarters. Come, and be on your guard.
It is too quiet here. Where are the brothers, or the abbot's men?
Does this have the stench of betrayal to you?
Why would the godly shepherd ally with the heretic?
Cunibert is a man who craves power and position. With Tedman dead, he must find it somewhere else.
There is truth in that. Keep your eyes and blade sharp.
It is too quiet here. Where are the brothers, or the abbot's men?
Cunibert, your guests have arrived. Come. Supper's ready. The dear abbot sent me a warm invitation, said my friends were eager to meet with me. It's early for supper, I know. But Cunibert's ale goes so well with roasted lamb and cinnamon blueberry peas. I couldn't resist.
Where is my brother?
Is he not here? Mon Dieu, I never told him.
Kill her, and we'll never find Sigurd.
Sit, Eivor. Eat. And let me tell you the tale of a man who talks with gods.
You mock me. I've killed for much less.
Of course you have. Isn't that the way of this ugly world? We call the sheep and thin the flock as we see fit, you and I. Most who walk the earth are little more than talking blood bladders, wasted flesh. But not Sigurd. Sigurd is something else. Sigurd has been touched. He is deified. The gods, they speak through him.
You lured him in with that lie. Your words are bile and blight.
You should have listened, Eivor. I tried to tell you. The gods are real, and their power is within our grasp. You will never find him. Not till I have had my fill. To old friends. This really is delicious, Cunibert. Is it cloves I taste? Well, that concludes supper. Kill them, and bring their bodies to my sanctum in Canterbury.
They will be upon us soon. Maybe there is another way out.
Fulke let slip that her sanctum is at Canterbury.
She did. And with no cause. I'd approach the place with caution. It may be a lie.
It may be. But it's the only lead we have.
I hope all this innocent sacrifice is worth the trouble.
It's Sigurd, my brother. Of course it is.
Then come, let us dive into the maw of death. I was never keen on seeing my winter years. This will not be for nothing, Eivor. We will find Sigurd.
It's not just him. I want Fulke to suffer.
This land of summer, mists, and forests, dreaming darkly. I see secrets, and I want to know England. all of it.
And yet it rounds on us at every turn, snarling like a cornered dog. I begin to despair of ever settling here.
Perhaps the stars light your path, and you will never have a home here. I have long been away. It's beautiful beneath the vanity, arrogance, and pettiness of men.
I should like to see it.
You could if you wish. My father was an architect, a builder of wonders. The great mosque of Samarra, his masterpiece. Another man who played the caliphate's game better took the credit. He was exiled and died in poverty.
Your faith sours. What of loyalty? Shared stories round the hearth. Warm nights, bodies, and the tender love of another.
There are some who are worthy. A scant few, a tower above the sullied mass. Men and women of vision and valor.
Sigurd is one such man.
He is. Fulke isn't wrong on that score.
I fear for him, Basim. I cannot rest until he's safe.
Nor will I, my friend. The practice of learning has waned considerably in England since the days of the Romans. What books they still have, they keep locked away in their churches, hidden from the eyes of common folk.
Thralls and Gerald cannot read. What would be the point?
They could learn. The church could teach them. So much of human history would be open to them. Aristotle, Pythagoras, Euclid, ancient knowledge lost to all but a few hard-headed men of the cloth.
You have studied these works yourself?
In my youth, I was consumed with a passion for understanding. I spent many hours a day in the House of Wisdom in Baghdad.
A seminary?
A great library, full of the greatest learning of mankind. For a boy seeking answers, it holds many riches. One day, I was sitting cross-legged. This place swarms with Fulke's people. Sigurd will be well guarded. Caution and subtlety should be our path.
Ready? Follow me. Sure and arrogant, and she cannot see failure in man.
Her fearful wit would say otherwise.
To arms, Basim!
So we are to blunder in like an ox. Whatever we find there, keep your head.
You chastise me like a child, Basim.
I guard you like a father. Nothing is served with your brutal end. You have much to do in this life,
I know it.
More riddles, Slytum.
No riddles. I sense a greatness within you both. Your destiny is not to stain the stones of this godhouse with your blood.
This must be the way to Fulke's sanctum.
Then let us go.
Fulke! I'm here! Face me!
Have a care, Eivor. You will play into our hands.
The plans to the great fortress in Wessex. Is there something here we can use to breach it? What does it mean, these word tangles that speak of elves and demons? By Odin, this is a sick tapestry she wove. For every drop of his blood she spilled, I will take a mead horn more.
Trained soldiers there.
We must be sure. Sigurd is running out of time. Anything else?
Documents of interest to the Hidden Ones. Hyden will surely want to look. But for Sigurd, Porchester is our only lead. If he is in Porchester Castle, we'll need a massive army to crack its walls.
I have many friends in England now. If I call on them, they will come.
They will.
Basim, she severed his arm clean off. Can a man survive such a loss?
Physically, he can. Mentally, it's hard to say. So much stress can drive a man to despair.
If you suggest he might take his own life as Tedman did, banish that idea. I must tell my people at the settlement that their Jarl remains a captive. They will not take it well.
We will not fail again, Eivor. I'll scout ahead
and send word to the settlement when I know more of Porchester. Be ready.
Wounds touching those made by Saxon weapons. I know where to look for my prey. May you feast in Valhalla, warrior.
Fecit Dominus Nostra Sapiens. Collecta supra in terra atheres. Et locustus est.
Even when it is Come on.
This is not the first time I've heard a scald sing through tears.
It's my beloved Ostrid. She loves me no more. Thus my quill stays dry. No poetry falling from its once proud beak.
Can you only write verse when you're in love?
Surely. I've not written a ballad about God since I was a girl. Only love moves my heart.
Some of the best verses I've ever heard were thrown in battles of wit and rhyme. Not lovesick crowing.
Oh. I have never seen such a battle. Please, enlighten me.
In our battles for glory and blood, we do sing and give praise to the High One, for Odin is king. And we beg that the High One will give us his nod, that we someday might dine alongside our war god.
Yes. Yes, I see the bricks of this verse. Fight, knight, brawl, Valhalla... No. Odin's hall. Get me my quill.
I should like to hear what music you write. Will you perform it somewhere?
If I can get Keener Wolf's bastardly face to help me with this meter. But you will have my thanks in this performance regardless.
Yeah!
police around here. You have my gun.
Help!
Oh, grant me strength. Hold, father!
Truth and love have been shackled by these dogs on...
You disagree with the terms of your captivity.
If love be a crime, then yes, I do. But I'm only guilty of such a boon. Me, Keener Wolf of the Gleeman.
I see. And whose wife did you bed?
Oh, the guard captains. And the alewife Luger. And he's an ace muse. But who am I to deny women my company?
A scoundrel and a poor friend.
That may be so, but this scoundrel will play naught but the sweetest music for his freedom. You understand? I, Keene Wolf, have been freed from my bondage and am eternally in your debt.
Make good use of your freedom, then. Apologize to your friends and stay out of trouble. Isane, Kit, and Keene Wolf. That is all the Gleeman. Now we'll see if they play the square.
Doesn't hold a flame to the intensity of ease on his old one.
Come one, come all! Friends! Fans! Lovers! You demanded our reunion and thus God has gifted our merry trio with just such an assembly!
With fresh poems bestowed on me by a new muse! One with a heart of a warrior and eyes of frost.
And two, three.
I love you, Keene.
Nearly friends of fighters, yeah. Come one and come all. May we meet up once more inside Odin's great hall.
Speak with Hytham.
Salutations.
What do you have today?
striking look coupled with an efficient design. Thank you for your patronage.
Have you got a contract for me?
My agents are not meant to undertake these tasks, but you, you are more perilous. The target is a just think of the reward while you work.
I must be on my way now.
Keep motivated.
Goodbye.
You go on, I'll still be here.
Hi, Eivor.
I have something that may interest you.
Thanks!
I must take my leave. So long.
Farewell, Eivor!
May I see your stores?
Is that what you want? You like the looks of that one? I can get you that one easy. You have a keen eye for quality. All my pieces are good, but that one's very good. Thank you for trusting me to have with your gear. Pretty good. You like the looks of that one? Nothing else I can do for you?
I will see you later, friend.
Fight well, Eivor.
Who do you work for? Who is your lord?
Eivor, you should hear this.
This Bakrot and his friends had the foolish balls to raid Ravensthorpe.
Are the others dead?
A few. Most of them escaped. They did not damage much, but made off with some of our gear. Should I get Randvi?
No. She has enough on her table. I will handle this. So, you thought you would play at Vikinga, little man. Are you prepared to go all the way?
You won't get anything out of me, Danish scum. I'll never talk.
I'm Norse. And what makes you think I want to hear you talk? Maybe I will take my payment in flesh. Chop off his leg. It does not have to be a clean cut. No need to sharpen your blade.
No, please! Don't cut off my leg! It was Sir Edward who wanted your stuff! He paid us to do it!
Sir Edward?
Yes, the Earl of Westerna! Or that's what he calls himself. Said he hates Vikings, your lord especially.
Where can I find this Sir Edward, Earl of Westerna?
I don't know, I'm new! We were supposed to steal the gear, then meet at the longship west of Ravensburg. That's all I know!
You can take him to Randvi now. Maybe we can trade him for a pig. I'm off to check out this longship.
Is that it?
I'm off. Be well, friend.
Goodbye, Eivor.
You hear that? Thor's testicles. What is happening over there?
Have you ever known anything like this?
What is going on?
Across the river! The animals have lost their senses! My very pig chewed through her fence and plunged into the river. She tried to swim across!
Oh, I have seen crows attacking one another. Perhaps this is serious.
It is concerning. My raven may see better. Tune in! Yes.
Sunan herself has lost her course.
Something must be done.
Do you think we are in danger?
I will look into it.
Huh?
this England. Hard. Some locations are marked. Workshop of a madman. Pulling together quite a horde.